Yeah, welcome. In this video, let us understand how to make Aadhaar Card PHP project. It's an online PHP project using the XAMPP server. So XAMPP will contain three products. So one is Apache server and the MySQL and the PHP. So once it's installed, we can run the XAMPP server and you can see that these two are very important. One is Apache server, one is MySQL. You need to start both. So when it started, it is in green color, indicating that both are working. And then you need to create your project folder in the XAMPP HD docs folder. If you are installed the XAMPP in C drive, immediately in C drive, this is the XAMPP folder. Under this, there is HD docs, and you need to create your folder inside the HD docs. Here it should be. And in order to run the project, you have to go to browser, you have to type localhost/, and the folder name. What are the folder name? You need to type that particular folder name. And this particular project is concerned, it will have three modules. One is admin module, employee module, and the agency module. So let us understand what is there in each module. Okay, so let us take admin module. So admin can log in. After login, it's a main page. That's how the flow should be, okay? So once you log in, it should go to the main page. In the main page, you'll have options. So we can enter the state names. So then you can enter the city names. In each state, what are the city names? Or district names, you can call it as a district also, it's okay. Then qualification. So this qualification for employee as well as the members, enrolling members. Next one is profession. What is the profession of the people? So next one is the employee details. You need to create the employee here, because this admin means, so this is an organization, so other organization. So in here, who are the employees working? So the admin has to create the employees. Then employee can able to log in here. Then here is the agency approval. Agency means, so who are authorized to enroll the people, because only organization cannot enroll all the people across the country. Therefore, we'll authorize the agencies to do enroll. For example, post office is one such agency. We can go to post office, you can enroll yourself for the other. Therefore, like that, there are many companies can do the enrollment. So therefore, there we need to approve that agency here. Then you can able to see the Aadhaar card list. Now employee is concerned, employee can log in. Here they can able to see the new applications. So what are the applications agency can create, they can able to see it here. They can give the approval, so they can check all the details and they can approve this. Then next is the approved list. What are is approved, that list will be there. Then the agency list. Who are the agency registered with us, that list they can able to view it here. Now agency is concerned, agency can sign up. Once they sign up, their details will be coming to admin. Admin has to give the approval. Once they give the approval, they can able to log in. They can go to main page. Here they can do the enrollment. So once they do the enrollment, the new applications will appear into the employee. Then employee can give the approval. They can put pending, you can approve the status, all you can do it in the employee. So here they can able to see the status, what happened to their card, what happened to their application, that they can see it here. And then here is the complete list, what all enrollment is done. Then approved list, which are the cards are approved, that approved list will be there. So these are the options which is there in the agency. So these are the things we need to implement, we need to write in PHP along with the HTML and backend as a SQL server, combine everything, and when you run the project, these things should happen, okay? These things should happen practically. That's what very important. We'll show the demo now. So before getting to this work, what I suggest to you is please watch another video, one more video, that is how to create and run PHP first project. So in this, we explained in detail how to install this, how to run the XAMPP server, then how to create your project in HDocs folder, then how to run the project, then how login page works, Then how we can go to main page. Lot of coding is explained in this video. So therefore, if you wish to do projects, please watch this video. It definitely you will get maximum benefit from this. So now let us look at the project demo. So if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. So next to our channel name, there is a subscribe button. Click here. And this subscription is free actually. You don't need to pay anything for this. But if you subscribe to our channel, this definitely help us to improve the number of videos and also quality of the video. So therefore, you can bring you good content. Therefore, you can learn from our channel. So please subscribe to our channel. So here is our channel, iBlix Tutorials. And when you click videos, and you can see that here is how to create and run the PHP first project. So you can click on this and then you can watch the video. And here is the subscribe button. So please click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. So here you can see that this exam server, sorry, exam folder. This is the htdocs folder. Inside this, there is a one more folder called as PHP 101 Aadhaar Card Project, and under this there is one more folder called as Aadhaar Card Web. So here you can see that all our files are there. So altogether it's around 42 files are available. So in that project concern, it's around 30 to 35 files are related to the project. Now next step is to create the tables. I'll show the tables, what are the tables are required here. So the database name is Aadhaar Card Data, and here is the login table. This is the qualification table, profession table, state table, city table, and this is the employee table, and this one is the agency table, and here is the important one, member table. Overall enroll, their data go to the member table, and here is the status. It will show the status, what is the status of this. Now all these table you need to create in a phpMyAdmin. So in order to create in a phpMyAdmin, you have to go to localhost, then you have to go to phpMyAdmin. And you can see that Aadhaar card data, we already created all these things. So if you want to create them, you have to go to SQL and then copy and paste it here. It will create all the tables. This is the one step. So next step is you need to run the project. So therefore you can say localhost slash. So you need to give the folder name. So therefore I'll just come back here. I'll copy the folder name. So we have two folders here. This is the main folder, and under this there is one more folder. So I just copy the both the folders, and then I can paste it here. And if I press enter key, it'll take to the main page. So from there, here is options. So I just click admin login and I can go to admin. So here is the admin options. First you can enter the state name. So if you go to state name, let's say Kerala. Okay, so Kerala state. So if I click submit, I can see that record is inserted and the message will come, record inserted successfully. Now if you come to the phpMyAdmin and if you go to state tab, you can see that Kerala is inserted here. So how we have done this? So that is done in the this particular page called the admin state. So if you open this page, you can see that this is the page. Here we are including the edit file, then you are including the config.php. So what is config.php will do? So I think it's already opened here. So if I open this file, so this is to connect to the SQL server. Okay, so here you are using the function MySQL IE, and this is the host name, that is the localhost, user, that is root, password is empty, and the database, this is the Aadhaar card data that we included here. So next is server request method, if that is equal to post. So when it will be post, if you call the same page again, then it's a post actually. So that is called here in the form, method is equal to post action admin state.php. So here you can see that form will be closed over here, and we have a button called as a input submit button. When you click the submit button, we'll call this file again. So that time the method is a post. So otherwise here you can see that state name and details. State name will go to text one, this is the text one, details into the text two. When you click the submit button, so we call the same file, and that time this method is equal to post, that is becomes true. Then text1 data will go to T1, text2 data will go to T2. Then we are insert statement here. We insert into state tab values T1 and T2 that go to variable called as SQL. And then connection query SQL, So we try to execute this statement. If statement is true, means record is inserted. If statement is equal to false, means record not inserted. So therefore here we say false, therefore you can say record not inserted. If it is else, it's record inserted successfully. So this message will be stored to the RES1 and that will print again, PHP echo RES1. So because of that one only, so it will print the message record inserted successfully. So this is the logic how the code works. So same way it works for city details, we can enter the city names here. Then qualification, we can enter the qualifications. So parallel you can see the list also, like okay, there are three city names you already entered here. So now qualifications, we entered two. So for example, you can write as a doctor here, MBBS, right? So doctor is MBBS, let's doctor, right? So if I go to qualification list, you can see MBBS is added. Profession, what are the professions? Okay, so that I can write like housewife. Now if you go to list, it is there here. So then employee list, there are two employees already created. You want more employees, can be created over here. So here are the option, what type of employee is, so that you can decide. Next is agency approval, agent approval and the card approval. So this is only a list will come when agents are signed up. Now what we'll do is we'll log in as an employee. For that I'll just copy the main folder names. Then I'll paste it again. This is the, in case of website, we link this folder to the website name. So when the server allows the static IP address, then we link, like, you know, that is a domain name server. So your domain name will be linked to this particular folder. That time we'll have a website address. But now we don't have a website address for this. Therefore, you have to use the localhost, then folder name and another folder name. So here we are using a subfolder, therefore two folders. Now you go to employee login. Here I have BBB and password. Password is wrong. Okay. So if password is wrong, the message will be shown over there. So now it's okay. The password is correct. Here is a new application list. Okay. But any new application list come only if the agency will provide the enrollment. Okay. Now there is an agency sign up. I'll go to agency sign up. So there is called as a RayTech. Okay, let me take as a RayTech only. Password, and then we'll retype the password. This is RayTech. It's a company who wish to take up the agency in a particular state. Okay. Now take this address, a mobile number. Okay, I'll take on dummy email ID. And this is for the Bangalore. Okay. If for different city, then you have to choose the different city here. So submit this. Sign up is successful, click here to login. But now they can't login because admin has to approve. Once the new agency sign up, admin has to give the approval. So here is the admin and here is the admin approval. You can see that new agency name or list will come here. We can click on that name, then it's approved. Means on clicking that, it will be approved. Now it's approved. Now we can able to login here. So therefore you can say RayTech, you can enter the password. So now it's there. So what they can do is they can enroll the Aadhaar card. So they can click on enroll. So here is the registration form. So when the person comes, so they need to enter all the details. Let's say, okay, Natraj, father name is Gowda. Right. So next is the address, Rajinagar, Bangalore, Karnataka. Okay. So mobile number, again I'll take some dummy data, right? So here is the qualifications. You can choose the qualifications. You can see the thing like former, okay, and gender male or female, and here is the date of birth. Okay, so let us take 1/1/2000. Fine. So after filling all these details, we need to submit this. So record insert successfully. You want to enter one more enrollment, you can continue here. But what happened to the one you already entered now? So now employee has to see that one. You can see that employee can able to see the data, and then you need to approve this. So here you can see that new application form. If I click on the number, so it will take to the details. You can see all the details. So it's a dummy project, therefore you don't take much details. But here you can see the photo and all other details can be shown. So here is under process. Okay, first step they'll put as a under process. Now if you come back to the agency and you can see card status, and if you enter the number, so here it'll show that is under process. Fine. So then after that they'll approve this one. Approved, save. So now there are no more approval required. So therefore it is empty. Now if you give 1002, you can see that card is approved and your card number is 1002. Or you can multiply four times, then you can generate the 12 digit also. Okay, anyway, it's a dummy. So therefore you can show that one card is approved. That is 1002. And here is the enrolled list. Who are all enrolled? That list will come here. And then here is the approved list. So overall this agency approved. So all the list will come over there. As the days goes, the number will increases and the list is also will increases. On the other side, employee. So you can see the card approved list. So which are the cards approved by this employee can be seen here. And then agency list, you can see the agency list. What are the agency, that list can be seen. Same admin can also see this one. So agent approval, that is what. And then agent list, what are the agents, that list is there here. And then card approved list, what are the cards are approved, that list also will come. But see that this mobile number and this mobile number both are same. It should not be, because in the enrollment, so two people cannot have the same. Okay, sometimes they can have it, but once you have an other card, you need to link to your mobile number to other card. Fine, no problem, but we can always stop this. Okay, we can tell whenever you are entering the data, when you go here, when you submit this data, so we can check whether this record is already present or not. If it is present, we can tell the user, okay, this number is already register with other number. So in order to do this, you have to go to agent-enroll.php. So here is agent-enroll.php. So edit this. So now you can see that here is the post when you submit this page. So mobile number, probably this is 7. So here you need to check. So here is to generate the new number. Before that, we need to check whether this mobile number is used by any other member. So if yes, then you can give the message, okay, this mobile number is used by other member. That is possible. Anyway, please try this. So probably you'll get an idea. Okay, thank you very much. And if you have any doubts, so please write it in the comment box and let me know what doubts you are having. And please subscribe to our channel. So as I told already, your subscription will definitely help us to bring more videos. Thank you once again.